वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, प्लीज ड्रॉ योर अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स द ब्लैक बोर्ड्स। आई ऑलरेडी मेंशन द टॉपिक ऑफ द लेक्चर दैट इज नोन एज पेनल सिस्टम ऑफ स्पंजेस। आई गिव ए लेक्चर रिगार्डिंग द कैनल सिस्टम ऑफ द स्पंज टू यू। यू नो the sponges are the organisms which are belonging under the phylum Porifera. Porifera means these are the porous organisms. Entire body is perforated. Canal system is the lifeline of this animal. If you reveal to the body wall is a diploblastic. Somewhere also radially symmetrical, or some cases also be asymmetrical. To take the section from the body wall, you must find one canal system in them. Okay? First of all, I'll give one introduction regarding the canal system in sponges. Water forms the main source of food, materials, and oxygen for aquatic animals. The suspended food particles in water and dissolved organic substances are the main source of nutrients for lower aquatic animals. All the activities of the body of the sponges depends upon the current of water which are entering through the ostia and passing out through the osculum or in plural oscula. Inside the body, the water current flows through the system of the spaces, which called collectively known as canal system. The system of the spaces, which collectively constitute the what? The canal system. The perforation of the body of the sponge by a large number of ostia are the characteristic features of the phylum Porifera and allow the entry of water laden with the food and organic nutrients to them. Okay, if you reveal the organisms like sponges which are belonging under the phylum Porifera and your shop division is known as the parazoa. You know, these are the metazoan animals, and metazoa differentiate as the eumetazoa and parazoa. But this phylum belongs under the parazoa. Okay? And in parazoa, you find the sponges, and sponges are perforated organisms. Entire body is perforated. Incurrent pores are must be seen in them. Those pores are called as dermal ostia. Generally, the dermal ostia are allowing the incurrent water to come to inside of the body. After the canal system in the body wall, the body also possesses a large cavity at central. That is called as central cavity, or also be called as spongocele. Okay, and that cavity also be called as the what? Gastrovascular cavity, so called gastrovascular cavity. It is also called as spongocele, or also be called as central cavity. Okay, and the canal system is the lifeline of these kinds of organisms. By the water current, food, that means nutrients, as well as oxygen, generally come to the bodies of these species. So what is canal system? Question is arise here. What is canal system? What type of function generally performing for this organism? You see, a distinguishing features of all these sponges is the perforation of the body surface by numerous apertures and for the ingress and egress of the water current. Inside body, the water current flows through a certain system of the spaces which one collectively forming the canal system. Canal system is the remarkable feature of the spaces which are belonging under the phylum Porifera. Poriferan organism generally possessing such characters. Okay, in there actually water current plays vital role in the physiological activities of these kinds of spaces. Let us know about the function of water current. The most vital role in the physiology of the sponges is played by the water current on which their life depends. All exchange between the sponge body and external medium are maintained by means of this current. Food and oxygen are brought into the body and excreta and reproductive bodies or units generally carried out. And this current is caused by the beating of the flagella of the gular cells. Okay, and after this you see the all the physiological activities which generally exhibited by the organisms which are belonging under the phylum Porifera, and your canal system generally performing very vital physiological activities. Okay, and by them the organism can able to sustain in the universe. The major physiological activities of the sponges depends upon the water current, and exchange between the body and the external medium is also maintained through the water current. I also explained before, food and oxygen are available to the cell and through this current, and while the excreta and reproductive bodies are excluded through this current. Okay, a typical canal system is composed of an incurrent canal, radial canal and prosopopile. So which are the important ingredients by which the canal system is constructed up and performing the water circulation? And these are nothing, these are called as the incurrent canal after the ostia. Ostia is the plural term, singularly it is called as ostium, and it is the incurrent passage through this way. Generally the incurrent water comes to the body, that is called as ostia. Secondly, you find incurrent canal. Incurrent canal. One canal is present which will receive the water from the outer environment, and that canal is called as incurrent canal. After the incurrent canal, you also find in there another structure that is called as radial canal or excurrent canal. Thirdly, you find radial canal or excurrent canal. Okay, fourthly, you find the large cavity which was named as spongocele, called as spongocele, or that is called as paragastric cavity. Paragastric cavity. Then lastly, you find one opening, that is single opening through this way. Generally, the expelled water expelled out from the body to the outer environment, that is called as oscula. Okay, you you must find these things. What are the factors which are present in the canal system? Ostia or ostium, incurrent canal or canals, radial canals or excurrent canals, and spongocele, or you can say paragastric cavity or central cavity. Last, you find the ostiums. Okay? And in these ways, generally water current moves. Where the water comes to the body, which is laden with the oxygen and nutrients, that is called as incurrent water. When comes to the body through the body valve, it will be called as excurrent water. And nutrients, oxygen already received by the cells, and those cells expelled out of the carbon dioxide and nitrogen waste product and repulsive units to the excurrent water. Finally, that water eliminated out from the body to the outer environment, from the spongocele to the outer environment via or through that is called as osculum. That is only one exit passage. Through this way, generally excurrent water comes to the outer environment. Okay, and if you recall the detail about the canal system, minimum you must find your ostium or ostia, then you find incurrent canal, then you find radial canal, and before coming to the spongocele or paragastric cavity, you find one passage, narrow passage, that is called as the prosopite. Prosopite, that is named as prosopite. Okay? And minimum, the prosopite must be remained in there. From incurrent to come to the radial canal, you must find prosopite will be there. And prosopite generally allowing that water to come to the next canal system, next canal part of the canal system. Okay? More detail about them. A typical canal system. The typical canal system generally deals with an incurrent canal. Secondly, the radial canal or excurrent canal. Then you find the prosopite. These three features are very important to construct a typical canal system. Incurrent canal, it opens externally to the outside by a small pores, which are named as, in plurally, ostia, singularly called as ostia. But internally, it ends blindly. The radial canal or excurrent canal would be remained after it. And it is closed externally, but opens internally by minute pores in there. And that one is called as the apopite into a central cavity or the paragastric cavity or spongocele, and which cannot be composed in any way with the stoma or intestine of other animals. Students, you know in there one door-like structure that is named as prosopite. It is a smaller canal or passage or way connecting to the incurrent canal with the radial canal. You see, the canal which you have seen in the body wall of the sponges, somewhere also equal in size, somewhere also it is different in size. Okay? And due to dissimilar, they will be called as heterocoela. If they are possessing same canal system, they would be called as homocoela or isocoela. And here, this chamber and this chamber is not equally diameter. And due to dissimilar, it belongs under the group heterocoela. Okay, however, the canal system somewhere also very simple, somewhere also zigzag and more complex in there. Okay, and you must find here, this is one part of the canal system, and this pocket-like structure is called as incurrent canal. And at the outer, you find one slit is there, which one is called as ostium. It is named as ostium, which will allow the water current to come to inside of it. Then, when the water current disperses there, immediately goes to offward. And at the end, it is blindly closed. and it comes to the upper throat and slit. And that seat is called as prosopae. It is called as prosopae. Prosopae. Okay? Which allows the current from the what? Incurrent canal to excurrent canal or radial canal, which is aligned by the choanocytes. And that canal is called as radial canal. It is called as a radial canal or excurrent canal. And this is the incurrent water. On the way, all the oxygen molecules which are laden in the water received by the cells, and nutrients also received by them. In lieu of them, they will be eliminated, carbon dioxide, nitrogen waste products, as well as reproductive units. Okay, and discharge the same to the excurrent water. And the excurrent water generally brought to them and discharge the one canal, large canal-like structures or pocket-like structures in the middlemost part of the body, which one is called as central cavity, or also be called as spongeous seal, and it is also known as paragastric cavity or PGC, paragastric cavity. Okay, and finally, that water eliminates to the outer, flowing only one slit, which one proximally present, that is called as postulum, which is named as postulum. Okay, then to know the types of the canal systems which you have noticed in the body of the sponges which are remaining under the phylum Porifera, and the course of the water current inside the body by various sponges differ according to the arrangement and complexity of the internal channels. Secondly, in the gradual and continuous process of differentiation of the sponges body, four distinct grades or types of the canal systems are seen in the phylum Porifera. These are named as acinar type, cycnar type, lymphnar type, and rhabon type. First one is known as acinoid. Acinoid. Second one is known as cycnoid. Known as cycnoid. Third one is known as lymphnoid. Known as lymphnoid. And fourth one is called as the rhabon type. Rhabon. Rhabon type. You see, you find four categories of canal system in the body of the sponges, and first three are very common in the sponges. A rhabon is a special type of canal system which one see in the very rare growth of the sponges. Okay? And today, I shall explain you only about the acinoid type of canal system. Acinoid, A-S-C-O-N-O-I-D. Acinoid, canal system, C-A-N-A-L-S-Y-S-T-E-M. It is very simple type of canal system, and it is the simplest, and in which water circulation is accomplished. Body is thin wall, radially symmetrical and hollow due to the presence of a central cavity called the spongocoel or paragastric cavity or central cavity that opens to the outside by means of circular aperture, which one is named as osculum, at the free distal end of the cylinder you can notice it, and that one is called as osculum. The body wall of the Ascon type of sponges is formed by two layers. Outer lining layer is known as ectoderm. Inner lining layer is known as endoderm. Outer lining layer, which one is ectoderm, generally formed by the pinacocytes. So it is called as pinacoderm. Ectoderm or epiderm, otherwise called as pinacoderm. Likely, the inner lining cell, which one is called as endoderm, that is generally constituted by the cells of choanocytes, so it is called as choanoderm or gastroderm. Okay, the endoderm formed by the flax-shaped cells called choanocytes, while the ectoderm is formed by a thin and flat cells called the pinacocytes. You must find two types of cells. One is called as pinacocytes. Okay, one cell is called as pinacocytes. Pinacocytes. Other is known as choanocytes. These are the two major group of these cells which are noticed in the body of the sponges. Okay, and your pinacocyte cells usually noticed at the epidermal region, or choanocytes are noticed at the endodermal region. Okay, so the endoderm usually formed by the flax separate cells, which are called as choanocytes, while the ectoderm is formed by the thin and flat cells, which are called as pinacocytes. And due to constituted by the pinacocytes, the ectodermal layer is also be called as pinacoderm, while the endoderm otherwise called as the choanoderm. Between these two layers is a thin mesenchyme form of the non-living gelatinous, that solution remaining there, that is the substance, and this substance has no cells. Okay, sometimes some cells also be coming to there as a modified manner, and that region generally constituted by them, that is called as a mesenchyme. Mesenchyme contains the different kinds of amebocytes and triradiate spicules formed by the calcium carbonate. In case of the sponges, you must find after the canal systems, you find one exoskeletal structures which are called as spicules, and spicules also be one significant character of the sponges. Numerous minute pores of the ostia are also be present in the thin wall of the cylinder, and these minute pores are regularly disposed the intracellular aperture, and each of which is a canal-like structure situated within a tubular porosite. You can notice in there some sites, some type of cells after the pinacocytes known as porosite. Pinacocytes and porocytes. And pinacocytes also modified into porocytes. And these porocytes are producing pores at the central part of the cell structure, in which way generally the incurrent water comes to inside of the body. The incurrent pores called the ostia extends from the external surface to the sponges and finally to reach at the spongocoel. In case of the asthenoid sponges, the water current passes through the incurrent pores, and due to the beating of the flagella, and flagella generally possessing by the choanocytes, and when they undulate, automatically the current would be developed and also direct into the water to come to inside and enters into the finally at the spongocoel or central cavity or paragastric cavity. Then the water then passes out through the osculum into the exterior, and the course taken by the water current may be shown in the ingressing water, and finally that water reach at the internal part of the body and through the dermal pores or ostia, and internal ostia allowing them to reach at the the canal system. Finally that water reach at the spongocoel, then from there spongocoel water leads to the outside as excurrent water known as the osculum. Osculum is the exit way, so this way generally excurrent water eliminated to the outside. What are the examples? In case of here, examples known as the lipocholenia. Lipocholenia or clatharina, these are the examples which are possessing the ascular canal system in their bodies. Generally, the canal system is identified at the body wall. And body wall generally possessing the canal system. And at the central part of the body, after the canal system, you find a large cavity is there, and that cavity also be named as central cavity, spongocoel, or also be known as paragastric cavity. Finally, the water also expelled out to the outer environment through the osculum. Osculum is a singular structure, but ostia are the plural structure. Number of pores are there which are remaining in the body surface. Those are called as dermal ostia, but the when excurrent water expelled out by the exit way, which one is called the osculum, it is single in structure. And this is the description regarding the ascnoid sponges. You see the diagram of the ascnoid sponges, in which you find the ascnoid canal system. This is my rough sketch of the your ascnoid sponge. It is also colonial organism. You need to find some spicules are remain. These are called as oscular spicules. And you find some spicules also remaining inside of the body wall. There are also traverses through the outer side of the body wall as exoskeleton. Just inside of it you find the canal system. You see the my pain marks, which are then tossed outer to inner. These are nothing, these are the canal systems, which are called as ascnoid canal systems. Only in there you find one way. So this way generally incurrent water comes to the body. Thank you. not more complicated, it's very simple type of response. You mark one arrow mark. This is the rough sketch of the Asknard sponge, and this layer which stands in the outer side, it is called as epidermis. Epidermis, otherwise it is called as ectodermis. Ectodermis, due to constituted by the pinacocytes, it is called as pinacoderm. Pinacoderm. The cells, flat cells are which are present in the after constituted egg. These are called as the pinacocytes. And due to constitute that layer, that is called as pinacoderm. And you see, you can say that epidermis or ectodermis, or you can say the pinacoderm. Likely, inner lining layer is known as endoderm. Endoderm. Okay, and it is also be called as gastroderm. Called as gastroderm. It is otherwise named as the choanoderm because it is constituted by the choanocyte. Choanoderm. Okay, and at where you find the yellow mark, these are nothing, these are the slit through which the internal water comes, and that is nothing, outwardly it is called as dermal ostium, named as dermal ostium or dermal pore. Is otherwise named as dermal pore. Dermal pore or dermal aperture. Dermal aperture. Which are allowing the incorrect water to come inside. Okay? At the internally, you find a space that is called as spongocele. Spongocele, C-O-E-L. It is otherwise named as paragastric cavity. Paragastric cavity. Or central cavity. It is called as central cavity. Okay, you can remember any one term. I all the places presented three terms. Okay, then you find the what? The spicules. Here you find the spicules. These are called as muscular spicules. Muscular spicules. Singularly it is the spicule, which are generally composed by the calcium carbonate or silicon oxide. Okay? And you find the your body spicules. These are called as body spicules. Body spicules. Singularly called as spicule. It may be triangulate or tetragulate or pentagulate in forms. Okay? And you see, in there, here you find one slit, which one is called the ostium. The water current comes through the one canal system, which one is equidiameter. That is called as incurrent canal. This one is the incurrent canal. Finally, that water reaches towards the outside through this apparatus. And that is called as here prosopite. That is called as prosopite. Only one door is there. And that would be named as prosopite. The one gate, which one is present, at the end of the incurrent canal, it must be called as Prozoa pipe. If the gate is present at the end of the your excurrent canal or called as a radial canal, it is known as apopipe. But here it is called as Prozoa pipe. The Prozoa pipe generally allows the water to come to spongocene. And this one, which one generally marked at the gap, this space is called as what? Oscula. It's called as oscula, which will allow the water to go to outside. Okay? And these are the description of the your ascular canal system of the sponge. In the next day, I will narrate you about other three canal systems to you. Thank you. Also.